Do you want to hold your hands?
No, 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 just one.
Obviously, I'm here because IWC completes 150 years, which we actually just celebrated in Geneva, and we decided to come to Dubai as well with it, and to, you know, just celebrate 150 glorious years of such an iconic, classic brand that I have had the privilege of being a part of.
Right. So, you know, being part of the film industry, you love so much more than acting. There's red carpet, there's, you know, airport look, there's street style, you know, appearances. Yeah. How much pressure do you guys have?
We have a lot of pressure, but it's only if you accept it and take it. Yeah. Honestly, I just think it's more important to enjoy everything that you do. So even if I'm dressing up, it's for myself. Right. It's not for anybody else.
Exactly. And approximately how much time does it take, you know,
to dress up for what? No, I mean, not that much time. If it's going to the, you know, airport, I don't wear any makeup, and I, unless I'm just like moisturizer and a red lipstick, that's it. Or I just don't wear anything, because like, it's really bad to wear makeup and get on the flight. So unless I'm like shot all day and I don't have time to, you know, change my makeup or take off my makeup. Otherwise, as soon as I get on the flight, I remove all my makeup, you know. So it's much, much better to just be as comfortable and casual. So I'm always in flats, 99% of the time, unless I have an event to go to or I'm coming for an event. For red carpets, maybe an hour, hour and a half. Depends on the outfit and how difficult it is, complicated it is. And for shoots, 45 minutes, like for photo shoots. And everything else, maximum, the longest I've ever taken to get ready is an hour and a half.
Okay. I think we've always been very vocal about the fact, you know, about the amount of time it takes to get ready for the red carpet or, you know, for the cons event. Do you want to tell young girls that it's okay to be themselves and it's okay if they don't have, you know, the body that we see on magazine?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it's so much, there's so much pressure for all women out there right now, especially because of social media, Instagram, and all these, you know, Insta celebrities, as you call them. And there's so much Photoshop and filters, etc., etc. So, you know, everybody needs to understand that everybody doesn't have to be that way. In fact, the more unique and original you are, the more you will stand out and the more, you know, beautiful you look. And I think it's just about being really healthy. Like, if you're healthy, doesn't matter what size you are, you look gorgeous. You know what I'm saying? It's like about exercising, eating right, you know, wearing clothes you're comfortable in. If you have a healthy body and a healthy mind, you won't need makeup. You know, or if you want to wear makeup because it's like art. Don't think of it as covering your flaws. Think of it as enhancing your artistic expression. You know, I think that's the way you need to look at it. I mean, I'm not one of those people to say don't thread your eyebrows or don't wax your upper lip. Do it if you want to do it. Do it if you don't want to do it. Like, the choice has to be yours. Don't do it because society is asking you to do it. I like to shave my underarms, but I think it's beautiful when someone doesn't do that. You know, I don't, like, you know, everybody used to think that being a feminist is burning your bra, but being a feminist is having a choice and having equal opportunity. So whether I'm going to wear a dress or trousers should be my choice. It shouldn't be, whether I'm going to wear a burqa or a salwar kameez should be my choice.
Also, since we were talking about diet, you've turned vegan, right?
Yes, I'm vegan.
You're vegan now, so is it? Are you enjoying, or is it a bit difficult? Do you get tempted?
No,
to eat
I do get very tempted, but I try not to be. I'm trying to be as careful as I can with my food and making more ethical choices when it comes to, you know, everything. But you know, I love bags and shoes, and I love. So with food, I mean, it's easy to avoid cheese. And I've never eaten meat, so it's fine.
Also, Sunam, you are an ambassador for so many brands. How did IWC happen?
So, you know, honestly, IWC was trying to, was coming very strongly into the Middle East and into India. And you know, so for them, I think it was looking at a perfect fit that understood the brand. My grandmother used to have an IWC watch. So I think it's nice, and I've had an opportunity to be I don't become a brand ambassador very easily for brands. I'm very picky about what I choose to do. And if you notice, I've been a brand ambassador for the same brands for many, many, many years. I don't kind of switch brands. You can identify very strongly the brands that I'm a part of. So IWC was one such brand. So when they came to me, I was like, okay, I've had several watch brands ask me to be the brand ambassador, but I decided to do IWC.
Okay. Are you the kind of person who would say no to, you know, fairness, female coaching, or cola?
I mean, it depends. It depends on, you know, what I feel. I try to be as ethical as possible, and I try to understand where the brand is coming from and what they're doing. But yes, I do say no to a lot of brands. You know, if I don't feel they are, you know, it's not something that I ethically believe in. So yes, I do.
Okay.
But I don't think I've done anything that is not okay to do.
Never. Also, Sanam, you have like a film. Pooja was fabulous.
Thank you.
And we've got so many exciting movies that are coming out. There's Veer Di Wedding, there's Sanju, there's Zoya Factor. Do you want to tell us something about, especially Veer Di Wedding?
Yeah.
You know, I'm really looking forward.
So, after, I think, Padman was my last film, which had an amazing response. It did very well, and I got a really good, like, I got excellent feedback from my character, and what it was such a feminist film. And Veer Di Wedding is, again, a film which speaks about women and girls, you know, in a difficult age, you know, which is the late 20s, early 30s, and you know what, you know, you actually do become women, I think, in your 30s. And you know, so when you're in the late 20s, early 30s, you're very like, I feel like I know, because I'm 32 right now, and I know exactly what I was going through in my late 20s. I was very stressed out because I didn't know exactly who I am. So it's a very, I think Lady is that, it's very entertaining, it's very commercial, but it's so real. And I don't think India or the world has seen an Indian film like this ever.
Cool. So is that a road trip?
No, it's not a road trip. You have to see the film. It's explosive.
Absolutely. And what about Sanju and
So unfortunately, I can't speak about Sanju. But I'm very excited to be a part of it. I have a small role in it, and I'm excited. I'm also doing Ek Ladki Ko Dekha, which is with Raju Hirani and Vinod Chopra again. And they're producing the film, and Shelly Dhar is directing it. And Zoya Factor is produced by Aarti Shetty and Pooja Shetty. And it's also Fox Star Studios, and it's directed by Abhishek. So I'm excited about this film.
Also, no, I know you don't really talk about your personal life, but there are so many.
I know, but unfortunately, I don't speak about my personal life.
Okay, absolutely. But do you believe that marriage will change your career path, or you know, your role as ambassador?
I don't think when a man gets married, these questions get asked.
Yeah, that's so true.
So unfortunately, I would refrain from answering those questions as well. I am someone who. My job is as an actor, and I don't think that job will change no matter what my marital status is, single, divorced, or married. I hope I don't lose my job, because I think that's extremely.
Sonam, you are one of the most fashionable person from India. Do you think you've ever made a fashion faux pas?
Have I ever made a fashion faux pas? I don't believe in fashion faux pas.
I don't believe
that you make wrong choices. I think you make choices. Yeah. And whether I feel like you have to be comfortable in a plastic bag as you could be in a couture gown. Yeah. So, you know, it's what people like and don't like. I always like what I wear.
Absolutely. Do you credit your mom for, you know, your style?
I think I credit my mom, and I think I credit my sister, but I also credit my mom. Like, I'd like to express myself.
How is that reason happening? You know,
it's going to be 1 year of reason, and it's doing so well. Yeah. And I'm so excited with the response we've got. We're trying to expand the market to.
Just come to Dubai.
I know we're trying.
Yeah.
Alicia, when's that happening? She runs
it's
reason.
The new year.
In the new year?
It's our second year.
Yeah?
Okay.
Awesome. How much are you involved creatively?
In fact, because my sister has Veer Di Wedding coming out, and obviously there's Cannes and etc. We are trying to kind of I think I'll be designing this line by this one by myself with obviously my sister's inputs. So this is very involved, extremely involved. Yeah.
So how do you find time for all this when you've got your own app and you are really active?
Yeah.
And you've got Reason, you've got so many amazing movies coming out
with an excellent team. I think your team makes you, you know. Mm-hmm. And if you don't have a good team, yeah, and if you don't have a good, you know, support system, it's, yeah, very difficult to do everything. Also, I have a lot of discipline. You, yeah, have to have the correct, yeah, discipline,
exactly,
of sleeping on time, waking up on time, being, yeah, happy, healthy.
Yeah.
You know, I think that's the most important thing.
What's an average day in the life of someone?
What is an average day in the life of someone? I wake up early in the morning. Mm-hmm. I have 2 bottles of water, I have my tea, and I work out, mm-hmm, I go for work, mm-hmm, 99% of the time, break for lunch, come back in the evening, chill with my family and friends, and sleep. Mm-hmm. And if I don't have work, I'm usually traveling.
Yeah. And probably you should tell, I think you always inspire having such business because you take out time to read.
Yes.
Right? You,
yes,
read a lot.
Yes.
Maybe, you know, you should tell more young people, you,
yeah,
know,
I think
to get into the habit of reading.
Yeah, reading is something that, first of all, exercises your mind,
yeah,
because we've lost the heart of reading. It gives,
yeah,
you patience, it gives you, it makes you smarter,
yeah,
I feel. It makes you more evolved and smarter as a human being.
Yeah.
And reading and traveling are 2 things which I feel are essential to grow as a person.
Yeah. Do you think we need to make a lot of noise? You know, it is very important to have discussion, especially because
I think to have a point of view,
yeah,
is very, very important,
yeah,
for us to have. To have a say, a point of view, a voice, it's very important. If you don't have that, you kind of, you know, will end up living in a bubble, which,
mm-hmm,
is not good.
Exactly.
Because you can't affect change,
yeah,
in any way, especially if you have a platform.
Mm-hmm.
So having a voice is very important.
Mm-hmm.
But using your voice at the right time is also important.
Exactly. As a female, you know, as a girl, what do you think can be a solution, like not be a particular solution, but, you know, in terms of something that can lead up to, because as a female, I feel really sad, you know.
Well, I think education and awareness are 2 things that need to be there, that need to be there in India,
mm-hmm,
which I think we lack. We don't,
mm-hmm,
have education. We are a predominantly illiterate country,
mm-hmm,
and I think it's important to educate.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. Cinema as a person, what makes you happy?
Being around my friends, being,
yeah,
around my family,
yeah,
working,
mm-hmm,
and traveling.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And what really inspires you?
What inspires me is people. People inspire me. People's emotions inspire me. That's how we can act. And you know, beautiful things inspire me.
Yeah.
And beautiful things, I don't mean like superficially, but like, could be a sunset.
Yeah.
Be, you know, 2 kids in the park.
Mm-hmm.
I just think it's important to get inspired by things that are very real.
Mm-hmm.
And,
yeah,
beauty is in everything.
Exactly. Have you seen any good movies recently?
Right now I just saw The Post, which is amazing.
Yeah.
Okay. And you know, that was the last film that I saw which I really liked. And yeah.
Okay. So now, what is your best style buy so far?
What is my best style,
yeah,
buy so far? I think I just bought this watch.
Okay.
Which is the IWC Da Vinci 150-year, you know, limited,
yeah,
edition watch.
It's diamond?
Yeah, it's a,
wow,
diamond-paved watch. It's beautiful.
And what's your go-to dress?
My go-to dress,
yeah,
is just a black, simple maxi dress.
So, do you repeat your dresses often? Or
I repeat my clothes all the time.
Okay.
I have this one denim jacket from Reason that I like live in.
Yeah. Okay. And your go-to watch?
The Da Vinci simple rose gold IWC watch that,
mm-hmm,
I have.
Okay.
It's just amazing. I have. It's just a plain watch. It's just really classic and beautiful, and it's got a gorgeous leather strap, and it's brown.
And shoes?
My Givenchy,
mm-hmm,
shoes that I'm wearing actually right,
yeah,
now. They're just a small pencil heel,
yeah,
just black strappy.
And what's on your current wish list?
My current wish list, I love the new Jimmy Choo's Rossi shoes.
Okay. I know you, there was a time when you were really into online shopping. Do,
yeah,
you still shop a lot online?
Yes, I shop a lot online.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what's your favorite city to shop in, why?
My favorite city to shop in, weirdly, has suddenly become Dubai.
Really? Wow.
Yeah,
amazing.
I used to not be like, oh, not so excited to shop in Dubai,
yeah,
but I think the shopping has just become so much better. The best collections I have.
Yeah, yeah. But Like, are you able to shop peacefully in Dubai?
No, not really. But you know, they've. I think we have so many personal shoppers, and it's just so convenient to shop now.
Exactly. And what make, according to you, what makes or breaks an outfit?
What breaks an outfit is overdoing it, like over accessorizing and too many colors. What makes an outfit is keeping it simple.
And who are your favorite designers?
My favorite designers are Elisa, Ralph Russo, Ananda Khanna, Abu Jan Sami Khosla, Anuradha Kheer. I love Celine, Chloe, Ashi. We have so many good designers these days. Rosie Arsalan, Alaya, very, very good stuff.
And my last question to you, what are the kind of goals that you want to do? How do you want to shape up,
I'm trying my very best to take up roles that are evolved and that kind of make a difference in some way. But now I think I want to do something really, really commercial. So let's see what happens.
Do you think writers have started writing, roles keeping female actors?
Not as much as they should.
Okay, cool. All right. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
It was lovely talking to you. Thanks a lot.